All right, welcome everybody. Hello, my name is Peter Draws, and today we are going to be looking at some fan-made watercolor creations, okay? And I almost didn't make this video today because of this pimple right here on my face, which I have, over the past couple of days, been absolutely brutalizing, but it has been standing up to the torture and just hanging on for dear life, I guess. Anyways, let's hop right into it. Here's the tweet. All right. I put this tweet out. It said, now taking submissions for the next Peter Judges viewer art vid. Reply here. Four simple rules. Okay. Watercolor theme. The piece can contain other mediums. Include your name / screen name in the pic, or it will be anonymous, right? So whatever pic you submit, I just right click, save it, and then I go through him. So if you don't put your name in it, it's going to be anonymous. You can either, you know, use just like something on your phone to put your name on it, or put your name next to it on the desk and take a picture. There's multiple ways to do it. It must be your own work, and one per person. A lot of people didn't go along with this rule and this rule and this rule, you know, but it's okay. All right, first up, I am going to look at just a few pictures submitted by people on Patreon. These drawings are not inherently better, they just are inherently first. Kind of a pay-to-win thing due to the fact that they give me at least $1 a month. I hope you understand. All right, here's the first one. This person didn't put their name on it, but this one reminds me of some, to be honest, this is amazing. First off, it's amazing. This reminds me of some picture I used to see. The only like real art class I took when I was in college before I dropped out of college was like an art appreciation class, you know, because they have to teach you to appreciate art. I think it actually might have just been an art history class or something, but there is some famous picture. I think it's originally of Jesus lying in the tomb like this. Hopefully someone knows what I'm talking about. And it's supposed to be famous because it teaches maybe about like foreshortening or something. Something that this person did pretty well with. And then they took it and turned it into some crazy robotic brain surgery thing. And it looks good too. I like it. Nice line work. Gruesome detail. Open guts too. There's a little camera. Just, I like the ambiance, the atmosphere in this one. This one's a little bit eerie. Like, I don't know if this is just like a cable or some sort of tube of blood. It all kind of disappears up here into the darkness above. I hope he's going to be okay. I think the artist gave some dramatic name to this, but I can't remember it off the top of my head. Oh, let me see. Oh, it's called Dr. Draymond's Experiment. Oh, wait, they gave me another one where they added their name onto it, but I didn't save that one. I'll just tell you, their name is Martin Haag, H-A-A-G-H. So I apologize for not using that image. Martin, I'm probably saying your name wrong. I apologize. But here it is. And it's a great drawing. I like it a lot. All right, here we have another one. This really pops out. I think the powerful part about this one is that, first of all, these white borders here really help to separate the foreground from the background. Also, I'm a big fan of this golden. Is this like actual gold leaf? Like, you can buy a lot of different gold leaf stuff. I can't tell if it's gold leaf or just gold paint. It's pretty, though. I like it. Also, I like some of this watercolor paper you can get that's like all rough around the edges, you know? Like, what do? Do they like crease it and bend it a bunch of times and then tear it? This part bothers me a little bit. This whole section down here is just plain white, but I'm guessing it was supposed to be like that for some reason. I don't know why, but, you know, you're allowed to do that if you want. It just bothers me a little bit. But not enough to, like, ruin the whole drawing for me by any stretch of the imagination. This is some sort of, isn't there like a medical emblem? Some sort of intertwined staff? What's that called? There's some special name for it. I like this orange, though. The orange and the blue. Really pretty. Here we have an almost, you know, it's a little bit cliche for me to say that it's a little bit Lovecraftian, but that, I'll admit, is what popped into my head first. Also, it kind of reminds me of those things that fly around in the Matrix, those hunter-seeker things, if it was more organic and less machine. I love this purple and the blue, though. Also, it looks like there's some sort of something pouring out of its mouth. If that is indeed its mouth, I haven't taken an anatomy course for this beast yet. I like how it looks like steam or like mist, but it's like pouring out like water. And this bulbous dome up top. It has good body to it, you know? It's beautiful. And eerie. Beautiful and eerie. And scary. So here's a watercolor piece that looks like they made a good use of the ability to tile something, you know, with computers after the fact. I think I might have liked it a little bit better if it was done slightly more carefully, you know, not to show the edge of the paper here and to maybe line this up a little bit. But maybe that was, sometimes it's difficult to get these to line up perfectly. I've tried stuff like this a little bit. Mostly I just mirror it once or twice. But this is really cool, especially when you zoom out all the way. Like, this could make an awesome tapestry or something. Or I could see this, you know, if I was walking through some weird alien temple, you look up and you see this, you know, across the vaulted ceiling. And you know you're somewhere that maybe you shouldn't be. You don't know what's going on here. I like it, though. This is sweet. Lots of cool patterns and stuff with the watercolor background. Really cool. Makes you curious to think about this little square right here was probably the original drawing. Then mirrored a bunch of times, tiled. It's a fun thing to do. I want to do that more. A snail. I almost said a slug. I guess it could be a slug and it got a shell stuck to its back. I guess snails go up in there a little bit more, huh? They have organs and stuff inside the shell. And do they have eyes? Are these their eyes they're supposed to be up here? I don't know how it works. I like its little mouth, though. That's incredibly adorable. And all the dots in the background. I like it. A cool texture. A little bit of shadow here. Rough. Kind of rough. It's a good like contrast between like this the gradient here and the, you know, there's like almost no texture compared to all the dots in the background. It really pops. It pops. It pops. Okay. Can't go. Let me go. All right, here we've got one. I think if I read correctly, this one is supposed to be a visual representation of overthinking things, which I totally get. I like how you have how there's this, you know, the careful concentric, you know, gradients, the colors that's calm, right? Maybe that's what it's supposed to be. This is how it ideally be, how you want it to be in the background. And then all your intrusive thoughts and everything, maybe that's what this scribbled black line represents. All this gets in the way. It messes it all up, you know. It can be frustrating sometimes, our own thoughts. I like this piece. I think it's safe to say it's downright interesting and colorful. That's nice about watercolors. Right, I think that's all the ones from Patreon. Hope I didn't miss any. All right, let's go to the ones people posted on Twitter. We have 77 things to look at today. Here's the first one, going through them in random order. And let me emphasize that this is, right, it says Peter judges viewer art, okay? This is not, I don't think I really have critique, a lot of good critique skills. This is judgment, hellfire, and brimstone raining down on you. Okay. But I'll try to be nice. I'll try to be nice. I'll try to have some sort of bedside manner. You know, I don't want, if I'm too mean, it's difficult for me when I'm reviewing people's art who are still alive, unlike some of my other videos where I review art by dead people. And, you know, I just don't want to hurt people's feelings too bad and then have my malpractice insurance go up. It's just this whole big thing. And mostly I just don't want to discourage people. And I think there really is an art to constructive criticism and encouraging people. But mostly I just want to go through a lot of these and look at some of the cool art people have been making. Today's theme is watercolor. This one's pretty sweet. Reminds me a little bit of Darth Maul. I guess I don't know if that's what this person was going for. I am comforted by how yellow the teeth are. I read somewhere that it's not really natural for your teeth to be completely, perfectly white. That's just like something they have put out in like advertising and popular media, whatever. It's pretty sweet though. I like it. Dark, the nice contrast and stuff. Nice, nice. Well done. I don't know where the rest of the chin is. That's okay. Chins are difficult. My chin, drawing chins, all of it. Got some more faces here. At first I thought this is two separate pieces of paper, but I think this is just two polygons on one piece of paper. Are these supposed to be flowers right here, do you think? These little splotches? Are they little cotton balls stuck to the face? I'm not really sure what's going on here with these. These look like flowers. I guess this one does look like a flower. Yeah, I think these are flowers. I don't know about that one. This looks like this was a marble, some sort of plaster sculpture or something, and some of it got chipped off. They look nice though, pretty. I like the purple background there. And I love yellow flowers. Okay, there's a soft spot in my soul for yellow flowers. Really cool. Okay. Some nice colorful swirls here. Look like some ink work. Very crisp ink work, by the way. Very crisp. Very crisp. What do you think? Do you think the watercolor came first? I bet the watercolor was there first and then the ink. Sometimes it's hard to tell which one went first. Yeah, I bet it was the watercolor and then the ink that kind of curled around what they did. It's nice to find a good sketchbook you can do watercolor in. Do you think this was actually watercolor? It might have been some weird pastels or something. Some of the pieces submitted here today, I don't think were actually watercolor. I mean, you might see them when we get to them. You know, some people skirting by on the rules. Here we have a cool one. I like this style. Kind of sketchy and loose. It says, this is kind of old. But I like it. I think I could see like a whole like graphic novel done in this style, you know? I like it. Everything kind of blending together as far as the, you know, like a few lines here, but then they don't draw any lines here across this, a lot of these borders and stuff, just kind of hinting at things. Your brain kind of fills in the gaps. Mm-hmm. Here we have, I guess these are seagulls. And I want to stress here that I love the water in this one. Water can be very challenging. I'm sure you can find, you know, like tutorials, how to draw water, how to paint water, watercolor water tutorials or something like that. But that doesn't just mean it becomes easy. I think this turned out really cool. And you can tell it's not just about the shapes, you know, there's a gradient of color change here. It's like bluish down here, starts being greener, a lot of, you know, cool grays and stuff. It's well done. Maybe these aren't seagulls. Do seagulls dip their beaks in the water like that? Look, there's even like a little bit of orange refraction in the water there where the beak is being dipped in the water. Once again, a lot of like implied lines there, like, I don't know. Am I using that word right? Another bird. I think these are called flamingos. I mean this. I don't know why I said it plurally. Like the little textures there, the feathers. The splotchiness is fun. Very cool. I bet that was satisfying to make. Splotching it all away. Are flamingo beaks really like this? I kind of want to go look at a real picture of a flamingo now. See if they're really shaped so goofy. What do you think they eat that they have to have a beak shaped like this? I think it's for like spiking fish out of the shallow water they stand in. This is a flamingo, right? I'm suddenly second guessing myself. I like it though. Really pretty color, so vibrant. And all the little white highlights here. I don't know how that was done, really. Maybe it could have done with just like a little brush or something. Turned out great. Really goofy looking, though. That's the bird's fault, not the artist's fault. All right, this one's pretty. Glorious, majestic. I almost said lion, but it's a tiger. You can tell, maybe I skipped the part in class where I was supposed to learn all my different animals. This one is a rich drawing. Lots of color everywhere. There's kind of like a weird halo around it. I don't know if that was, maybe that's just, you know, there's like a green halo around it. I think I like that. It's like it's glowing a little bit. Oops, I didn't mean to. Maybe, if anything, maybe like work on, I don't know if I like all these little textures in the back on the, on like the mountains and the grass. I feel like maybe this is one of those things where you draw the textures. This, do you think this is watercolor pencil? I feel like this is watercolor pencil, but this is just kind of how it turns out sometimes. I mean, it looks okay. This is like a pretty cool style. I don't know why I always turn my head when I look at stuff like this. Do you think this is like late afternoon, sun setting, purple skies, huge paw? This is kind of the watercolor stuff I do. See, I thought, I was a little bit afraid at first because when I said this one is going to be watercolor themed, I was like, is there not going to be much variety? You know, is it all going to be the same thing? I did it. I did watercolor theme this time because last time when I had no theme at all, there were like 400 drawings. And you know, I was sitting here for like 2.5 hours or something looking at pictures. So I thought if I did it themed, then it would whittle it down a little bit and be more manageable on my end. But I'm happy to say, you know, we have a lot of good variety here so far. Just because it's watercolor doesn't mean there's not a lot of different crazy things you can do with it. And this is kind of the thing that I usually find myself doing with watercolors, doing a bunch of different splotches and then coming back in with the lines and kind of exploring the shapes and contours and digging in there and fleshing it out a little bit. This turns out cool. They cut it, you know, it almost looks like they had like maybe some masking fluid on here or something to keep some of these areas clean. You kind of see like the brush strokes maybe where they put on the masking fluid, but I could be totally wrong. I like it though. Combination of lines and some stippling. The red and the yellow. Wow. This one is expertly done for sure. Look at that. Something that I've noticed time and time again that really pulls some of these together is doing an amazing drawing like this, an amazing painting, and then coming back in with like a little, like I think this is like a white gel pen, you know, like a jelly roller or something, and doing these little white highlights on the edge of stuff. It just gives it, makes it like glisten and glow a little bit, makes it pop out of the page. Do you think this is a little bit of gold leaf back here or something? Gold paint maybe? Around these circles? Could be. Looks pretty cool. I like the background too. Excuse me. Just had breakfast. I had a peanut butter and jelly sandwich for breakfast and some cold brew, and it was good. Really cool drawing. Can I call it a drawing even if it's a watercolor painting? Also, as I zoom out, I find myself looking at this circle. Do you think this circle is really the same as these circles? It's just the light's catching it differently? It's hard to take pictures of stuff like this sometimes because, you know, you have to get the light just right. And it's, I've had struggles with that. It's in a little frame or something too, I think. A glass frame maybe. Here's one from Brad. And he posted two. He posted this one saying it was for extra credit. And on the other one he posted, which I'm not including because there's only supposed to be one per person, he specifically detailed that he does all his drawings with like Prismacolor markers or something. This is exactly not watercolor. But it looks good. Okay. It's pretty cool. I like it. It turned out okay, despite the fact that you broke the rules, two of the rules. I like it anyways. For some reason, these remind me of pepperonis over here. But I like how the people are hanging outside the frame. I also like doing that, putting in like a little false frame into the drawing and having stuff kind of flap over the edges. Good job, man. Good job. Okay, here we are. Oh, a seascape. There are beaches that I used to go to also, which had cool piers like this that would go out far across the horizon. Just kind of like a weird little interesting, you know, architectural addendum to the horizon. But this is beautiful. First of all, this part, with a little bit of sea foam there, and then the way the clouds are all lit up and reflecting across the waves. It's pretty. It's just plain pretty. And by plain, I mean that in a good way. Really well done. This is watercolor? Do you think it is? Looks like it's on a canvas, but I guess you can do watercolor on canvas. I don't know. Whatever it is, I like it. It's hard enough to capture the beauty of a sunset just by taking a picture of it. You ever had that problem? You see a beautiful sunset, you take a picture, it does no justice, and eventually you got to come to terms with the fact that it's better to just sit there and enjoy it. But once you... I got to give some credit here to the fact that this is a painting of a sunset that I think does do it some justice. This could be a sunrise, too. Is there a way to look at a sunset or sunrise and know without a doubt which one it is? Some sort of atmospheric conditions, or I guess if you know what coast you're on, which way you're looking, that would help. All right, we have a garden scene. The more I look, the more I keep finding more snakes, which is a little bit terrifying. Actually, this one looks like a little dinosaur. These two look like they could be dinosaurs from the Land Before Time. This one is definitely a snake. This one has a fat little tail. I'd like to think that this snake starts here and just goes right here. And just is like a little worm snake about 5 inches long. This one too. I'd like to think that it's only this long. Oh, it has a little hand. It's a little lizard. Is that its hand? Do you guys see that? It's less scary if it has a hand. It's a really pretty scene, though, with all the little flowers. There's not much, like, context to it, right? They're all the flowers are just kind of floating in the middle of nowhere, but that's okay. I do that with all my stuff all the time. I like it. Pretty. Thanks for sharing. All right, we have a statue that fell over in a lily pond. Really cool. I feel like that could be difficult to do, to figure out how to draw the contour of a statue like that so that it looks convincing. I want to zoom out more for some reason, but this program won't let me do it. Like the rich greens, the greenish blue of the murky pond water. Little vines and leaves and stuff. Real pretty. Whoa. This is crazy. Look at this. Some crazy dragon thing, and it's got other little beasts poking out of it. It's got like little nodules and warts, pustules. It's like disgusting, but at the same time, very lovable because of how, maybe because of the colors that makes it that way, or just the comical form in which it's made. Is this watercolor? I bet it is watercolor. I don't know why I can't tell. I like this style. Like even just like these little touches right here, these little things coming off the sides of the lines, you know. It's really, just really fun to look at. The more places you look, there's always just some other little thing. These kind of look like maybe it's some watercolor pencil action also. It's fun to look at. I like it. I like the yellow here on this arm. The yellow over here. I feel I'm a very big proponent of throwing in some yellow into pretty much any old drawing. It makes, like the yellow here makes all the rest of this look better. Just for the presence of it. It, I don't know. Really cool. Okay, got some dogs. Tessa, Toddy, Mr. Marbles, and Kermit. Probably a big fan of Kermit's eyewear and general fashion sense. Mr. Marbles is struggling a little bit. Toddy is a class act. The wink, and Tessa looks like she's taking a nap. But a great group all around. Just a beautiful, beautiful set of dogs. I like these. I like these brush strokes here around the eye. You know, really great way to approximate the fur and everything. That can be a challenging thing. Hair on people, fur on animals. Sometimes you get too caught up and you want to draw like, you know, every single hair, you know, and a lot of times you just can't do that. It's not practical. Here, you know, you didn't really draw any hairs at all, and it still looks like a great drawing. So you gotta learn how to overcome those things, I guess. I don't know all the answers. Someone after my own heart, drawing power poles and power lines and flowers in the sky. All things I love. I just really, there's something about all these, you know, all these lines that all clump together, you know, on the weird stuff they do on power poles, telephone poles, and then how they swoop off to different spots. And there's all these swoops and curls. And it's like, you know, it was intentional. They did all, it's not like it was an accident the way these appeared here, but it's not, they didn't do it artistically. You know, it's very utilitarian, but still it's very nice to look at. It's some weird collision of two things. I don't know how to explain it, but I like it. I could look at power lines all day. Even if there's not anything crazy happening on a power pole like this, even just driving down the road, you see them swooping along from pole to pole. You know what I'm saying? The rest of this looks good too, though. Maybe this is drawn on site. Maybe it's drawn from a photo. I don't know. Wow. Another good one. It's like the hanging gardens over here. What does this say down here? I don't know what that says. I'm not going to read in cursive. D-O-W-A-N-I-E. O-N. Duwami. Duwami. I love this style, though. You know, everything, it's like, it makes sense to your mind, but when you look closely at it, everything's like a little bit off kilter, but not too much that you don't really care. Like, it still all makes sense to your brain. And the colors look great. Love the kind of roughness of some of this. Even just coloring in these, is this like a greenhouse top or something? These are all slightly different colors. Some variation there looks good. We got some more power lines here too. A mossy stone wall. You know, someone told me the last comment I read on YouTube before I made this video on one of my last comment on one of my videos that I read was that someone told me that I should go see a doctor because I burp too much and that that's a sign of serious digestive issues and that they're very worried about me because I burp. Anyways, I love this. All the different little splotchy colors. The texture is amazing. That's what I want to say. And it's just like a little, it's like the terrarium version of a painting, you know? It's just like a little snippet, a little clipping taken out of the world here on the paper. Really pretty. Really pretty. We have some madness here. This one, I'm not sure. No, this one definitely the watercolor came first. You can see, you know, all these splotches of watercolor and come back here with some lines, have fun with it. This one I'm a little bit uncomfortable about. You know, it looks like maybe there's some nasty creatures in here. But I like these lines, you know, but that's just me. I know my own proclivities and tendencies are taking over here that I'm a sucker for lines. That's okay. People are allowed to like different things. Hey, if I ever say something here that you disagree with, that's good. Just disagree with it. This stuff, some of this is a little bit muddy. I mean, which is okay, because it gives it maybe some depth or something. I'd like to see this person keep going with this. Explore this, maybe this idea a little bit more. Keep it up. We've got a nice little two-story house. My eyes are drawn immediately to this railing. I love this railing for some reason, like the way it kind of is, it must be bowed out here for all of this. You can see, kind of see it here. It gives in a nice 3D effect. I like how not all the lines are, you know, completed all the way. Like we were talking about before, kind of implied lines. Mm-hmm. The brickwork. Subtle sky in the background. I'm saying subtle a lot, but it's a fun word to say. It's just, you know, it's just like one of those drawings that gives you like a whole feeling. Like you kind of imagine yourself walking up to a house like this. A little fence going around to the backyard. Just all this. I like it. I'm not laughing at this drawing, okay? I'm laughing because when this person submitted this on Twitter, I think they said, you don't have to include this if you don't want to, or something like this. And that's just like such a, you know, a normal thing for artists to do, you know? Right off the bat, so often we discredit ourselves. We cut ourselves down immediately, you know, before anyone else even says anything. We start giving excuses and saying, yeah, I know it's not good and this and that. It's just like, I think personally, all of us, but personally me, we just got to get better at just sharing things. Just put it out there. If you want to say something bad about it right off the bat, before anyone, you know, just try to, because maybe you're just trying to get to it before someone else does. Maybe just don't say anything at all. Just put it out there. I don't know. But I like it, okay? Yes, it's a little bit simple in the fact that maybe you put some tape here, and then, but look, I like it. The contrast between these stark white shapes and then these cool billowing clouds of yellow and orange, a little bit of brown down here. You got to make stuff. And this is something that this person made. Keep it up. Thanks for sharing. It's fun to look at. I'm sitting here having a good time looking at it. That's all we need. All right. Okay, so this person, you can see, I mean, this probably isn't the only one without a picture, but this person said, some school project I did early this year, IDK, how to edit my name in there. So if you could mention me, that would be amazing. I got you. This one's by Steve from Meme, or at Steve from Meme 1. It's pretty sweet, Steve from Meme. Very rough, splotchy. What are you doing? Did you load up a bunch of paint on your paintbrushes here? Flick it all around. I wonder what the assignment was for school. I see two figures here. Pile of brown, and maybe a throne of brown here, and they're in a cave of brown. They have a brightness about them. Something redeeming is going on here. There's something raw about this, especially about whatever this redness is here. Maybe it's just part of her dress. But the splotches really all do tie it together. The splatter, I guess, is the better way to say it. And I like the tablecloth, too. Keep it up, Steve, from Meme. Okay. This person said, I think that this is a take on a Egon Schiele portrait, self-portrait, which I totally see. And I'm a big fan of Egon Schiele. And I totally see the correlations here, the lines being drawn from one to the other. I like this a lot. Particularly, I mean, this is a praying mantis, I guess, which is really creepy. But like the background and these little plants, which Egon would always add, you know, really captured that well. Is this really watercolor? Like, this is a really cool effect you got going here. Really creepy praying mantis thing going on. It's whatever it is. I think you nailed it. It's like I want to keep looking, but I'm also uneasy to keep looking, which is a great, you know, great thing to accomplish. But also I want to mention that the background, it's tough to leave a background rough like this, you know, rough where you can see all the brush strokes and scrapey scratches and stuff, but also have it be satisfying that way. Because a lot of times I struggle with my backgrounds. I want my backgrounds to be polished and, you know, smooth looking so that they don't distract from the drawing too much. But there definitely is something I think you've accomplished here where the background is a little bit rough and rugged and it adds to the whole thing, you know, instead of distracting. It all pulls it together. I don't think I've really figured that out yet, personally. Right here we have a terrifying, coral spider. Oh my goodness. Not a big fan of spiders, but this one is pretty cute. I still don't want to be near it. It only has four eyes. Maybe these are the rest of its eyes up here. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 eyes. Aren't they supposed to have 8 eyes or something? Or maybe it's just 8 legs. This is a cool idea, though. It's a little seascape on its back. Little sea corally things on its legs and everything. And the color's beautiful. That would have bothered me so much. That little splotch right there. I want to extend my sincerest apologies and condolences for you on behalf of that splotch, okay? In fact, I shouldn't really have even pointed it out. That was probably pretty mean of me. Probably was. Good job, though. Huh. This is crazy. This is... Oh, no, wait. There's a siren coming. Hold on. Oh, wait. No, it went somewhere else. Okay. But no, this is cool because, look, mostly just because the contrast here between the dense lines of this lady's face and hair and hand, and then just how flat black this bird is. It's a cool thing to do. And the bird in her robe or whatever. Really cool idea. Despite the fact that this is just so fun to look at, all the textures here and here. That just looks fun to do. Making all this swoop up and around and all the little cross hatchings. It makes my eyes happy looking at that. And the color of the background. The mouth going up under the big nose, drooping down. Nice. There's a lot of weird decisions you got to make when you're an artist and you're like making these things. Like, I don't know if I would have made this decision to not color any of this in. I mean, maybe it's just gray, but, you know, I probably would have, you know, just taken my flesh colored ink, you know, and just gone, even gone all this, but, you know, they didn't. There's not really a whole lot of flesh coloring right here that I can see. Maybe there is. It's just playing tricks on my eyes, but it looks good that way. You know, it looks pretty good that way. That's a, you know, sometimes it's hard to tell what all crazy decisions people are making when they're creating things. They don't, and you don't see the crazy decisions when it all just blends together and works out well. You don't think about it. That's how you know it worked out good. All right. This looks like some sort of cool map. This is definitely one of those drop the ink on the paper, have fun with the shapes with the pen later. It's like someone had a lot of fun. I like it. There's some cool variety here, you know, just some simple green shape. And really getting in with the little tiny. Looks like maybe this is Michigan. This is like Lando lit. Or if you get like way north up in Canada, up in Russia and stuff, if you look on Google Maps sometimes, there's like thousands and thousands of tiny lakes that I guess were scraped out by glaciers or something. That's what that reminds me of. It's pretty though. I like that. All right. Breaking Bad. Heisenberg. I feel like the only reason this is a little bit weird is because this isn't taken at like the perfect angle. You know, it's not taken looking straight down. And I feel like maybe his neck isn't really that. But I was about to say maybe his neck isn't really that muscular. Not as muscular as mine. But you get to take, you, as an artist, you have artistic liberties. And especially when you're doing fan art like this, if you want to make them seem a little more, you know, intense and intimidating. I mean, he really did become a bit of a legend in that show. So go for it, man. That's awesome. This is a cool style, too. He's like, I like these contours right here in his forehead. And this going up here like that. It's crisp. It's clean. Well done. Oh, man. Is this supposed to be like the weight of knowledge, you know? You're holding all these books, this knowledge, and it stabs you through the hand or something? Or is this like how much you hate homework? Or, you know, I'm not sure. Pretty sweet. I mean, I like drawing swords. I need to draw more swords. Sometimes I would just sit around and draw different swords and knives and battle axes and stuff. I remember I used to do it all the time, like 15 years ago. I should try that again sometime. Hands, pretty challenging. Not sure I could have done any better. In fact, I usually draw my hands intentionally awful just to avoid this problem. A huge cop-out on my part, but you went for it. Pretty cool drawing, though. Dark black background. Nice little, I think this is a self-portrait, maybe? This looks like it could be in, like, an illustration for, like, a children's book or something, maybe. I mostly like how this outside the window is, like, some surrealistic jungle land. Little ferns and palm fronds and stuff, and just an endless greenness out there. Just the void of green with some leaves in it. And little flowers and stuff hanging down in here. I think it turned out good. Interesting feelings this one evokes, you know. Flowers poking out from behind the window frame. Mm-hmm. Sorry, I have struggles going from one picture to the next sometimes. Here we have an exploding bumblebee. Now, a little while ago, we looked at one that had paint splatters. Wait, does splatter and spatter mean the same thing? Like flammable and inflammable? Anyways, this is pretty cool. I wonder how big this one is. I want to know what the real dimensions are. This just looks different though. I like it. There are no crisp, fine lines in this. It's all rough and tumbly. It's all crazy. But you still know what it is, you know? It's like it's one of those dogs in the middle of shaking all the water off its fur. That's what it makes me think of. Really cool. Well done, well done. Oh, sorry. I'm going to sit on my foot for a minute here. You guys ever do that? Sit on your foot, and then after a while you realize your foot is hurting intensely. But I don't know why I started to sit on my foot in the first place, but for some reason it's comfortable at first. This is pretty. So I'm guessing, well, how did this work? All right, so first you work on doing the gradual background gradient, which seems challenging to me. First you do that, and then you come in and do this tree on top, which has, this tree has a lot of branches. I'm impressed with how many branches this tree has. Sometimes you can get carried away with the branches, or sometimes halfway through you get discouraged, like, ugh. Because if you go outside and look at a real tree with no leaves on it, you'll notice that it has so many branches. They just keep splitting and getting smaller and smaller and smaller. So kudos to Annabate for doing lots of little branches. All right. A collection of colors. I feel like this one could be one of those ones that would be at least twice as cool if it was like, you know, like 12 feet tall and like 8 feet wide. You see it up in the MoMA or something. It's cool how there's chunks, some crisp chunks of color, but also a lot of places where the colors are like blending together based on when this person applied them all and which parts were wet or not, you know. There's some interesting variety in there that way. Got a betta fish here. To be honest, I feel like I would like this more. Look, it's just me, but to be honest, I think I would like this more if it had a little bit more, something else to it, like a little bit of motion, maybe, like if it flowed a little bit more, or if it was a little bit imbalanced, you know, like if it was a little bit darker on one side and lighter on one side. It's just like despite how much is going on here, there's still like not much going on here. You know what I'm saying? That'd be my main feedback. Like, implement something else in here, some other element. You know, like a little bit of this or a little bit of that. Something. I don't know. This does look like a weird creature down here, though. A little weird bison fish or something. All right, so here's a betta fish, I think. This is pretty cool. Pretty cool how this part's all dark and everything. And this part, the fins in the back are like all translucent. I like that. simple, but well done. It even feels like it feels 3D, you know, like this coming off of here and this down here. It is a betta fish, right? Maybe it's a guppy. Maybe it's a blue goldfish, for all I know. It could be a tuna. Not a fishologist, but I like what I see. This one could also be a tuna, for all I know. But I think it's supposed to be an alien. So I guess you do the alien first and then draw the background and then maybe come in with like a paint pen or something around the edges here. This border does help a lot. This white border helps it pop. I like this little, the blue coloring around the eye here. Kind of the sunken blue eyes. The weird thing is this one seems sunken to me, and then this one seems like it's bulging out. But maybe I'm just looking at it wrong. You know what I mean? I could just be looking at it wrong. But it's cool. I like these little splotches. Gives the skin some texture and everything, you know, makes it look a little more real and convincing. Out there looking up at the night sky, wondering if we are out there. We're here. Come find us. Oh, merman. That's cute. I like the little fin ears. I'll admit these pupils do creep me out a little bit, mostly because they remind me too much of goat eyes. Have you ever seen goat eyes? Very creepy. There's a few animals out there that have these creepy, like, infinity-shaped eyes, like weird, weird sh their pupils, their irises or whatever they're called, are not round, and they just skeeze me out a little bit. I like this take on the mermaid thing, you know, whatever this is. I feel like a lot of mermaids, you know, they would end like right here, and there'd be a fishtail right about here somewhere. But no, you took it on, extended it. It's like some sort of there's some sort of coral reef shark or something I've seen that has a longer tail like this. I like it. Good coloring too. Whoa. This is crazy to look at. That's my favorite thing about it. First of all, what exactly is going on here? Because it feels like a lot of like these. Does anyone else feel like these blue lines are almost on a different layer or something? Like they painted the stuff, right? Whatever this is back there. And they put like a piece of glass on top and drew these blue lines. Like they feel like there's like a little shadow behind all the blue lines, but maybe I'm just going crazy. And then know, sometimes this almost the background almost looks like a Google Images, like a satellite photo of some glaciers or something. There's some great textures and colors going on here. Whatever this is, I'm a big fan. All of this right here. Whatever's going on, I really like it. Yeah, I think I could look at this one for a while longer. It's inspiring to me. Got some sort of mechanical, industrial abomination. Poor guy. Machines in his mouth. That's what I feel like when I go to the dentist. They fit everything in my mouth at once. Like all the smokestacks, the contrast with the background. It's pretty sweet. These teeth do. I think I really do have a problem with teeth. All these crazy teeth, sharp ones. Notched, rotted ones. Little bit of the same color from the background and the eyes here. That's a good touch. Stuff slipping down the tops of the smokestacks as it all blows away. some more splotchy color play here. The lines, it's a fun one. Yeah, I like that. I mean, I could sit around doing this stuff all day too. It's just fun. I would recommend everyone try this. Get some watercolors. They don't have to be nice ones. Get some pens. They don't have to be nice ones. And then just lay the, just splotch out some colors onto the paper. And I say splotch. Maybe that seems like I'm putting it down, saying it's not a, not a, this is fine art. Okay. This is as good as it gets. This is the pinnacle. The apex. Looks great. All right. This one, out of all the tweets, out of all the replies, this is the only one. You know how Twitter sometimes hides tweets and they say potentially offensive content? And you have to click show tweets. This is the only one that was hidden to me on that, that whole Twitter chain. It's potentially offensive. I think we all know why. It's beautiful, regardless. Also, it looks like it has two eyes right there. I just realized that. It's kind of scary. I used to have a big rooster like this. Never let me come near it, but it was huge. Just big, like a, it was taller than my knee. How tall is my knee? Yeah, taller than my knee for sure. Huge plumage. This guy does not look pleased with what's going on here. But I like all the textures and the feathers here. That didn't take any short amount of time. Looks really cool. Good job. Ooh, here we have some sort of maybe like a bobcat skull or like a. I mean, if I had to guess, I would guess bobcat skull, but I could be totally wrong. Could be way off. You mean? Could be tuna again, for all I know. This is a cool color scheme, though. What do you think it is? What colors are all here? Sometimes it's hard to tell. All right, so we got blue. We got some shades of purple. But there also could be like salmon or something right here. But maybe that's just diluted purple. Could be like some tan. I don't know. It's really cool though. It looks like it looks and feels 3D. I like that blue right there. This little section inside of the socket. This part's weird. I'm not really sure what's going on right there. Does that feel unfinished to anyone else? Maybe it's not though. Maybe I'm just looking at it for too long. I feel like sometimes if you look at it for too long, you start noticing things you shouldn't be noticing. And that, for some reason, I really like, what's going on here? Like the just the texture, is that just the texture of the surface they were painting on? Or did they actually do that? I'm not sure. That's good though. Maybe there should have been like a little bit of a shadow right here, but now I'm nitpicking. To make this tooth pop out a little bit more. Getting nitpicky. I'm trying to go to the next drawing. I just don't know how. I'm like, it doesn't let me go if I'm zoomed in. Okay, there we go. Watercolor, spring-loaded something or other. Take a moment to absorb that while I get a sip of water. The background is great, all right? Like I said, yellow, it makes the rest of it pop. And this looks like some crazy yellow explosion in the background. Also, I just realized that this is actually its tail looping all the rest of the way around, which is good. I just thought it was some other random puff of fur. That's a long tail, though. I like the colors. The gradients on the stripes, you know? All the stripes start out blue, turn into what color would you call this? Cyan? teal? I don't know. Is this your quilt? It's pretty. All right. Some sort of tribal face. Three-nostriled demon deity or something. It's crazy. I feel like this is something you would find on the wall of an ancient burial tomb somewhere. And you would suddenly realize that you should not be here. Yes, sir, you are in the wrong place right now. You are dealing with things far beyond your knowledge. Otherworldly powers. Very intimidating. Posted at 1:54 a.m., which I think is a good indication. Oh, wow. It's like some sort of wood elf, some sort of forest nymph, you know? She's got mushrooms growing out of her shoulder, behind her ear, and off of her head. This would be impossible for me to not scratch at. You know? If I have, like, the tiniest little, like, mole or pimple or anything, I'm always, like, scratching at it and picking at it. And how do you let a mushroom grow behind your ear and not, if anything, just go doing, 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 play with it until it just falls off completely? I think this is supposed to be a tattoo on her shoulder. Really cool, though. It's pretty. Well done. Right? This is cool because it just shows a couple. This is like three different ways to draw clouds. Excuse these clouds. Oh, there's my digestive system. Die any second now. From burping. Here's clouds only made from lines. Here's clouds that look like driftwood. And here's clouds that look like they're being shot out with great force. It's cool though. I like it. I think these looked like they're fun to draw. Just working with the little textures and stuff. These ones. Hunks of wood drifting through the sky. Whoa, I did not mean to switch to this one already, but this is intense, man. This is crazy. Flayed. Have a fresh look. Is this some cosmetic medical procedure they're going to offer in the near dystopian future? I guess that is one way to get rid of acne. And have a fresh look. This is pretty though. Boom. Yellow background. Hello. Makes all of this beautiful. The hair is great. Look at that. Incredible hair. Winning smile. Just, she looks amazing. This eye looks like it might fall out any second now. Maybe she's just winking and she's like, that could be what it is. This is sweet though. Little muscle fibers and everything. I like this. You know, this is fun because, you know, it like, it puts a whole story in your head because your brain tries to give it some sort of context. Like, when would this be a thing? I like it. As grim and gruesome as it is, of course. Wow, another great portrait here. Look at that. Once again, incredible hair. Once again, a yellow background, even though I think that's just their desk. But I'm just a sucker for it. It's great though. I mean, I definitely am not good at drawing faces like that. I mean, I don't even almost know what to say except that it looks really good to me. Does anyone ever say this to you? Like you post something and then they say, wow, can't wait to see it when it's finished. And then you're like, that's just like the meanest thing you could have said to me right now because I worked so hard on this and it is finished, you jerk, you know? And you can't tell if they're saying that on purpose to be mean or whatever. But you know, sometimes you can leave things unfinished on purpose just to give it a little more of a unfinished look, but also to draw your eyes to the part of the drawing that is more finished. I think that's a legitimate strategy. And any other strategy. You can do whatever you want. That's the wonderful thing about art. Whatever you want. I like it, though. Some more ink splotches. Can't wait to see this one when it's finished. I'm just kidding. No, it looks great. I like it like this. This is the type of thing I always used to do, just when I was like watching Netflix or something, just do hatch marks. Not necessarily on top of watercoloring, but it's a great way to just practice drawing lines. Just get your hand used to it. It's just good for muscle memory, you know? I just fill a whole page with it. It's good for you. I like this part. This might be my favorite part right here. The thick black undulations with the orange watercolor, you know, kind of cutting through it. That looks sweet. It's like a weird oily orange river or something. Really cool. Stuck again. Oh, pretty. I think I want to live there if it weren't for the fact that I know there would be so many bugs. If I could somehow live there and there wouldn't be bugs everywhere, mosquitoes, you know, and cockroaches and just all sorts of beetles and ants and just flies and bugs everywhere. This looks nice because I'm assuming that you can go inside the tree there because there's windows and stuff. But it's nice. Like the fact that I saw this and I immediately started wondering about what it'd be like to live there, I think is a good indication. Got a little deck, some little stairs. I want to see more. I want to see the inside. I want to see the rest of the tree. I want to see the front yard. I want to see the whole neighborhood, you know? Really cool. All right, you know, on the flip side, we had the little idyllic forest home, and then here we have the dystopian futuristic wasteland. I'm assuming someone fired maybe from outer space, someone fired a giant rail gun and just flattened the whole city, maybe Superman flew through here or something. Or maybe there was one of those Kamehamehas where they both Kamehameha'd into each other and their blasts, you know, they were like, and then it was like, and they blew a hole in the mountain and flattened half the city. Who knows? Also, I can't tell if this is a real person or if this is a statue. Could be a person in a robe or a cloak. Could be a statue. This is not a good sign. Blood dripping out. It could just be coolant, though. Could be cherry drink. That's a good touch, the effect. The sunset setting right into that little hole in the mountain. I mean, the gaping hole in the mountain. The city looks nice. It's a cool drawing. I like it a lot. It's fun to wonder about. Very cool. I do feel like this is what most cities would look like after Superman had a battle here. Or any of the Avengers, or half the stuff that happens in movies. Godzilla. Ooh. two words that pop into my head, which I do say a lot. The first thing that pop in my head are crisp and vibrant. I like how many spots you left plain white, right? That you didn't color at all. I think that's a powerful thing to do sometimes. Like if I were to consider, I don't know if these are supposed to be teeth, but if I were to consider these teeth. Also, I think it says text right here. Just interesting. Does that say text? Probably just a glitch. It's okay. But you know what I mean? All these teeth, those really pop. Also, the texture of this stuff, you can see the paper. That's pretty cool. I don't know. And the varying line width, right? Look how thick these lines are. And then they got the thinner lines on the inside. That's super cool. Oh, yeah, they probably accidentally put this text here when they were trying to put this text up here. It's okay. This is cool, though. I like it a lot. And then even just little things like adding a little bit of shadow here with a little bit darker gray. You know, I bet that stuff's all over the place. You don't even really realize it just because it's just little things like that. Really clean. All right. This person, you know, I said one per person. They submitted one thing, but it had three things on it. Way to skirt the rules. Good job. That is cool. I like these little shapes you've included here. Like this person's disintegrating into their base polygons that they consist of. This person's bubbling away. Person looks like they have a crown of coral. I like all the colors you've got going on here, though. The warm and cool contrast. You know, like that's how they always do on movie posters. Look at like almost any movie poster ever, right? And you always see it's always orange and blue, all set aside and mixed together and contrasted. Orange and blue. That's what they always do. You've got a lot of that going on here, too. And it just looks good. Just looks good. All right, here we have a moose. It is a moose, right? Could be an elk, for all I know. Also, these are definitely eyes in the trees, are they not? These, that's not how, what are these supposed to be, birch trees? That's not how they really look, is it? If you go into a forest, they don't really have eyes all over them, do they? Also, this tree goes nowhere. What's going on with that tree? It just disappears into the antler. That's a pretty drawing, though. This horned beast is well done. I like the leaves. You know, you can just draw a few of the leaves. You don't have to draw every single leaf. Just hint at a few of them. Add some more clumps of color. The human mind will fill in the rest for you. We have powerful brains. We do. Oh. This is another one where, like I mentioned, I think these little white highlights go so far. Can you imagine what the... I feel like if we just took away these white highlights, like all these here, maybe a little bit here and here, this drawing would maybe only be half as good. You'd only be taking away a tiny bit of the drawing, but they do so much for it. The face, this face is pretty great. I feel like maybe the weak point here is this wrist and the hand. So we'll just look at it like right here, you know. But these are pretty butterflies. I like it. Maybe the nose seems a little weird too. I feel bad for criticizing such a beautiful painting. The background. Hello, yellow background. It looks good. Little freckles and everything. It's beautiful. It really is. Really is. Oh. Soak that one in for a second. Sorry, I'm like losing my voice. Right. Now I want to do something like this. This looks like a conglomeration of seashells, does it not? First of all, I just want to say how much I think the background does for this one. Splotchy blue background there. This just looks satisfying. There's so many little places for your eyes to get lost in, little curves, and I was about to say cuticles, but those are little pieces of skin on your fingernails, isn't it? Really cool. This one looks almost like a face right there. People see a lot of faces in my drawings too that I usually don't see, but I think that's just like, little eyes and stuff. I accidentally draw eyes all the time, but I think that's just like kind of a natural human thing to look for, recognizable thing. When there's like a huge mass of random shapes like this, we just automatically search for some sort of order in it, an eye sticking out of the depths of the darkness. Maybe that was done on purpose. Maybe it wasn't. Who knows? Maybe they're just drawing an oval and then drawing another oval around it, or I don't know. Could just supposed to be like an olive in there. It's really pretty though. I like that. Okay, here we have old Saint Nick. This watercolor? This almost looks like a. No, I think that's probably watercolor. Now this is a rough and tumble style right here. This one I kind of want to zoom out on even more. I'm gonna back up. I say that one looks even better if I zoom out, if I back way up away from it and then like blur my eyes a little bit. Yeah. Like his face really comes together into that evil kind of the evil grimace, like I think I can nail it. Watch this. Yeah, right there, right? Nailed it. It's cool though. No, hey, it's good. Hey, get a little scratchy and scribbly with it sometimes. It's not always the best thing to go very slow and careful. Just get your ballpoint pen out and just start scribbling. I support that. Support that big time. We got Davy Jones. That looks sweet. I like the. Sometimes when you look at something and you see it and you're like, yeah, Davy Jones, he has a kind of like a green face. Like seaweed colored or whatever. But it's like, this just. Something like this just goes to show how many colors you really can incorporate in there, We got green, yellow, blue, red. There's so many things going on. They all kind of merge together and make it convincing and satisfying for the eye. Yeah, it turned out real well. The worst part about drawing tentacles for me is all the little suction cups which you got. Usually when I draw tentacles, I just leave the suction cups off. I draw suction cupless tentacles. Which, I mean, I'm sure those exist somewhere. Maybe only in my universe, if not in real life, I don't know. Which is okay. All right, we got another th threefer. Cactus. Leaves. And this reminds me of one time when I went to Subway and they had their art hanging sideways. Like some, I think it was pears like this, somehow magnetically clinging to a wooden cutting board. They didn't, I don't know if they didn't even notice they had it hanging sideways. I like these. This is these pears probably are my favorite one out of these three. How you left these highlights, like the reflective spots or whatever. Just blank white. You're right. I'm guessing this is just the plain paper back there. Just nothing there, right? Except for a few splotches. You did do some the splatter, the spatter. It's a good effect. The background of this one does remind me. That's very, it seems a very, you know, like kind of Georgia O'Keeffean, right? Well done. I love these clouds. Look at them go. They each have their own little personality. I feel like you could make a web comic with all these little clouds, and they, you know, each one have like a little story or something. I didn't mean to do that. But yeah. Here we got some more tape action. Pretty sweet. I like it. The yellow, got some yellow in there. Mm-hmm. I like it. I like this pink. You can combine the colors. You can like mix, you know, watercolors on your palette before you apply them too. So if you don't have a pink watercolor, I'm not sure which colors you combine them. I guess just you just dilute the red a lot. I didn't really think that one through. But to get, you know, to get green, you can mix blue and yellow, I guess. This part looks very, a lot of this looks like it could be underwater. This the, not the last one, is it? Oh, I'm just stuck. I gotta figure out a better program for this. Hello. Let me go. It's like purgatory. I have to like zoom out all the way, zoom in a little bit. Help. This is art entrapment. There we go. Oh, I will. I think it's safe to say this one looks different than anything else we've seen so far today, in that it looks like a gummy worm geode. How is this one so colorful and vibrant? What's the secret? Is it the yellow? Is it the red? Is it just the type of paint? Is it the type of paper? What is going on here exactly? You know what I mean? It looks like a bunch of gummy bears were all melted together and sculpted into a giant blob. I love this color and these two colors next to each other. Actually, like all these, this whole section here and this and that. I like it a lot. It does seem like there's something else going on here besides just paint and water, but I could be totally wrong. Just the way some of it kind of splotched and dried. You know, maybe they did the thing where some people, you know, try different things like using alcohol, like rubbing alcohol, and it makes it dry differently, stuff like that. Maybe it's a little bit of that action. I like how you can see these brush strokes. That definitely looks different than any of the brush strokes I've been making with my watercolor on paper, so I don't know. It's pretty sweet, though. Candy for my eyes, if not candy for my tummy. Got some mushrooms on a suspended piece of soil. I will say that soil does look very scrumptious. And as much as a piece of soil can, right? A little, some little rocks in there. I think, what do you think these little dots are? Spores? Could be spores going off, like the rocks. I mean, the roots. Nice little background. I want to hold it. I want to cup it. I want to feel the moist loam in my hand. and have those mushrooms on top. And then I want to plant it back down into the earth somewhere. And it'll every, then everything will be okay. Whoa. This one's awesome. The plain, you know, the plain black and white skull, the vibrant flowers around it. You know, the there's multiple contradictions and contrasts here. The death, the life, the vibrant colors, the monochrome. But also it's just really, really crisp and well done. It's not sloppy. I tell this person took their time with it. But it is really vibrant. Also, this pimple makes it so it hurts to raise my eyebrows. I'll stop talking about my pimple. It's cool how you included these all these cracks, though. I guess the reference every image you're looking at had all those cracks. Sometimes you look at stuff like that in real life and you see, you know, you see that a skull has cracks like that or something, and it, you just see it, and then you put it into the drawing. And you're like, it doesn't even look right in the drawing, but it's there in real life. I guess that's like the whole reality is stranger than fiction thing. I like that a lot. All right. This looks like some more of that gold paint. Is this someone I should know? Is this like David Bowie or something? I feel like sometimes people do pop culture references and I totally miss them because I'm just not up on it as much as maybe I should be. Also, his eyes aren't exactly pointing the same direction, which is a little bit off-putting, but maybe it's supposed to be like that. Sometimes that's difficult to do. Also, some people just have a lazy eye, which is perfectly legal. Still a powerful image. Strong jawline. I feel like maybe this shadow should have gone up here a little bit more, but I'm not sure. You know, that's another one of those things, like maybe you were looking at a reference image and that's exactly where the shadow went. You can't do nothing about it. But, yeah. The fingers make me a little bit uncomfortable, but I'm just personally uncomfortable about fingers. That's probably why. Pretty sweet drawing, though. This is cool. Got like a, it's like a mixture of a landscape and a spacescape. Beautiful. This reminds me of a cherry tree we used to have in our front yard. I don't know if that's really supposed to be a cherry tree, but or any type of tree in particular. But I like it, and I like that it's kind of, you could tell it's kind of like backlit, maybe by this strange cosmic anomaly in the background. And who knows what's actually happening here? Is this thing being split in half? Is it being constructed? Is it a planet? Is it a space station? You know, is it an alien ship? Is it just a giant walnut sitting back there on the horizon with a weird cage around it? I think it's maybe the moon. They're bringing it closer. If I had to guess, that's what I would say, but like this path too. It's like a nice garden. Misty evening. Maybe morning. Once again, I'm still having the problem with telling if it's morning or evening. But it's pretty. Really pretty. Okay, you might be wondering here. All right, this person provided a little bit of explanation. They said it is a photo. This is a black and white photograph, which they put watercolor on to colorize it, which I think is really cool. And now I want to try that. We'll allow it, okay? There's watercolor on here. I guess that's what this purple watercolor. Yellow. Hello, yellow. Brown, some bluish, you know, green. I want to try colorizing a black and white photo with watercolor. That's what I want to do. I want to get like an old, I know this sounds super retro hipster crap, whatever. I want to get like an old black and white photo camera. What's the best, coolest way to do this? No, because then if you print out the photos, they'll be on like, if I get like an old film camera, right, and take weird photos of textures I like, I guess I can get them printed out on paper that's better for watercoloring on, right? Because it just seems like usually when people print out photos, it's on like glossy paper, but you can't really paint on glossy paper that well. I don't have a dark room or anything, so I don't think I'd be able to develop them myself at this point in my life. I don't know, I was just thinking out loud there, but that'd be pretty cool, right? I think it'd be cool. It's fun to daydream about anyways. All right, this one looks just like a pen drawing, but they claim that it was watercolor somehow. I don't remember exactly what they said, but they said it was some watercolor going on here, so I'll take their word for it. There's a lot of different ways to do watercolor, not just one way. Not all watercolor drawings have to look the same, you know, a bunch of swaths of color. I mean, it's just a watercolor pencil they used and didn't add any water. That could have been. It's pretty cool, though. Fun little scribbly textures for all the... I like this poof. This poof right here of feathers coming out. The eye looks good. Pretty sweet. Little feathers going back here. All right. I have some sort of flame sprite, maybe. Trying to decide if I would like this better if it had a face, but I don't know if I would. It looks, you know, this is okay, I think. It does have invisible high heels on. But looks like an uncomfortable way to stand is all. But maybe it's one of those, it might not actually have any weight to it. It might be touching its toes down, struggling to touch the ground because it's flames, you know. The physics of it could be all different. But, you know, there's some subtlety here. Look, it's orange, but look, there's actually a lot of blue going on here as well, which is an interesting choice. All right, I'm not sure if I'm supposed to know who this rock star is. If it's someone famous, I don't know off the top of my head, but this is a sweet drawing, a sweet painting. Got the capo going, 5th fret. Yeah, this looks awesome. Rock and roll, baby. Once again, the little white highlights doing wonders. A couple little hairs here, you know. If it weren't for that, a lot of them here on the guitar, too. I feel like if I tried to do this, I might totally forget to come back and do like white highlights. And it would just look kind of flat and dull and wouldn't pop as much as this does. But yeah, this is awesome. Just the way the light's shining down, the motion, like the power, you know, we're looking up at it. Pretty sweet. Pretty sweet. All right, rock and roll. Triangle nostrils, terrifying eyes. These are like warp hole eyes. Oh, man. It's like something from a horror movie. This is like a doll from a horror movie or something. Scary. Also, this looks like it's, I don't know, something about this paper looks like it's almost cloth to me. Anyone else? I don't know. I'm probably overthinking it. Also looks like it's in a sketchbook, though. I do like this little subtle little bit of pink here for the face. Huh. Also, don't recognize this person if I'm supposed to. I don't know if I'm supposed to. I mean, it could be. I don't know. I don't know if my favorite part of this is supposed to be the rug, but my favorite part of this is the rug. Also, it looks like maybe the rug took forever to make. I mean, that's a lot of precision detail work. It's easy when you're doing, you know, watercolors for a lot of things to overlap, and just one tiny little slip up, and you know, there's like a bunch of red where there's supposed to be brown or something. I don't know if they, looks like maybe they came back in here with like a gel pen or something and did a lot of these white bits, but still it looks really crisp and good. The perspective of this is a little bit weird. You know, the whole thing is at a sharp, you know, like 50, 60 degree angle, which is pretty crazy, and not in a bad way. There's just so much detail going into this. You know, every single item on the shelf is carefully rendered, kind of carefully. Pretty interesting drawing. Love the colors. Really cool. It's like one of those things you can just keep looking at and keep noticing more little things here and there, everywhere. Right here we got a bridge in the woods, maybe a park. Now this is gorgeous. All right, let me say this is gorgeous. The way these leaves are rendered, all the plants. This is some serious work right here. This is not something you just like stumble upon one day, I don't think, and just randomly find out that you know how to make leaves. I think this is something that this person went out of their way to figure out how to do, all right? All this shrubbery. Shrubbery. Okay, this is amazing to me. For me, there's something weird about this bridge that throws the whole thing off for me. Like everything in the drawing seems 3D to me, except the bridge. But that could be another thing where, like in real life, that's how the bridge looked. I'm just like trying to figure out where's the other railing. You know, where's the other part of the arch of the bridge or something? It could just be that we're looking at it straight on. I don't know. That just bothers me a little bit. But no, like that. Like, I could look at, like, this part of the drawing for forever, all these beautiful little splotches of green and slightly different hues and darknesses, all these little branches and everything. Look at all of that. I love that. I think there's, like, it's like a river right here, a little waterfall even. Really cool. All right. I have a tiny octopus drinking tea and or coffee and or hot ink with a mustache and a top hat. And this octopus is smaller than your standard issue Oreo, which is really impressive. Really minuscule. Really adorable. I like it. This one's pretty sweet. All right, so my main issue here, all right, if I was going to give you some feedback, I would say maybe put a little bit more thought into taking pictures of your drawings, because that's my main frustration at the moment, is these crazy shadows being cast across it, you know? It's like, why go to all this work to do this drawing and then have all these crazy shadows going across it when you post the picture? But, you know, maybe I'm being too nitpicky with the shadows and everything, but it's pretty annoying to me, to be honest. Then again, I do have a bunch of specialized lights and stuff, but I haven't always had lights. I have for a long time tried to take good pictures of my art. At least moderately good pictures, at least not with crazy shadows. You know, we're just, there's a big middle section that's brighter than the rest. But this is cool. I like all this. It's just fun to look at. I think there might be a little bit of the gold too here. I need to try working some gold into my art. Whether it's just like a gold pen or actual gold leaf, gold paint, I don't know. I've done a little bit once or twice here and there, but I think there's possibilities. This looks a little bit like Asian to me almost. What do you guys think? Cool drawing though. Cool drawing. Have a woman looking back over her shoulder. I think this is the drips are definitely a powerful effect here. Yeah, I like the drips a lot. I'm a little bit put off by how the hair, like, she almost looks beautiful, but then the hair looks like a matted mess or something. That's the only thing that bothers me a little bit. But it's still pretty. It's still a pretty painting. But this, I feel like this right here would just be like a huge clump of hair. But I'm probably overthinking it. Oh my goodness. It's like a feast for the eyes. This is like going to a Brazilian steakhouse, you know? And you should stop, but you never want to stop. You just want to keep looking. So vibrant. Could it go? Once again, I guess usually when I do my splotches of ink, I come back in with the black pen. This person looks like they came back in with the white pen, which really made it more vibrant. And then a little bit of the black pen too for like some shadows to give it a little bit of like as if there were layers to it. I love this blue right here. All right, the yellow does a lot, but this blue, amazing. It's like that one episode of that Netflix show where that guy was putting that shade of blue in all of his paintings. Maybe this is that by that person, by that robot. Wait, spoilers. Right, and then there's just dots all over the whole thing. And somehow it doesn't get tiring, the dots. Maybe they're bubbles coming up from the bottom of the ocean. And I'll be honest, I don't know what constellation that is off the top of my head. Really, the only constellations I know off the top of my head are the Big and Little Dipper and Orion. Maybe one or two others if I had some help. But now that I'm talking about the sky, I'm just noticing how beautiful this stuff is. This looks like crazy nebulas, and this is beautiful. I love this a lot. I didn't even notice this at first. You know those pictures you see of like freaking horse head nebulas and stuff like that? These are so well done. I love this. Beautiful. We got some vines coming out of a shoulder, out of a neck, cutting through the space hair. I think this is supposed to be a sea or like a crescent moon. It's a pretty cool drawing. I like that. It's different. This just really, this black is so black. Like, you know, it's hard. I mean, a tiny bit I can see some brush strokes or whatever, but it's really, really crisp. And this, hey, more gold ink. Wow. Looks good. I think that's it. I think that's all of them. All right. Thanks for watching, everybody. If you want to be included in a future video like this, just follow me on Twitter. I'll just do a tweet at some point in the future. Don't know when, don't know how. Sorry if I can't be more reliable on that front, but thank you for everyone that submitted a picture to this. You're all incredible artists. I'm just glad you're out there creating things, drawing things, sharing it with the world. You're all doing great. I think that's the most important thing. You make something, then you put it out there, and then you just move on to the next thing. It's okay if not the whole, you know, not everyone sees it, not everyone, you know, thinks it's the best thing ever. It's okay if you don't even think it's the best thing ever. It's just, I don't know. I think it's just, I don't know. Anyways, I'll see you later, okay? All right. Bye, everybody.